know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord. Now, I didn't say it. It said the Lord said it. He says that I have plans to prosper you, plans not to harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future. May I tell you, just because of where God delivered you from, that lets you know that God has plans for your life. Because some of us were in some stuff so deep. Some of us were in the wrong places at the wrong time. But God calls the right person and the right lesson to come. To let you know that, listen, baby, I've been here before. Who will you tell tonight? Listen, you don't have to stay in the pit. You don't have to stay in the ground. You don't have to stay beneath. You don't have to stay under. But I come to tell you tonight that where you are, I've been here before. I've been where you are. And I know God is able to bring you out. Glory to God. He's able. Just look at somebody and say, I've been here before. And I'm not going to be ashamed to tell the world that I've been in some dark places, that I've seen some bad things. But I know it was not for my own good. But I know it was because God was going to use me to pull somebody else out of the fire. Who are you witnessing to? Who are you ministering to? These four walls are not about us. But God says, I gave you the great commission to go out into the hedges and the highways and the byways and compel men to come. That my house, not the building, but the kingdom of God, that the kingdom of God might claim souls for the body of Christ. Who's willing to let people know that I'm not ashamed of my testimony? Because I've been here. I've been where you are. Just look at somebody and say, I've been there before. Oh, yes, I have. I've been there before. And as I get ready to close, I need you to understand tonight that you don't have to be ashamed of your past. Don't you let nobody keep you in a place of low. Don't you let nobody keep you under and beneath. You don't have to be ashamed of what you've done. You don't have to be ashamed of what you said. You don't have to be ashamed of what you've been. You don't have to be ashamed of your last experience. Because they're going to be for your fuel. God says, I'm going to use your past experience to be the fuel to conquer your new situation. How many people know that we always gonna go through something? But may I tell you that when you get over the lion and the bear, there's gonna be a Goliath that tries to step up in your life. But you know what? You gotta be like David and say, you know, this little Goliath ain't nothing, because I've been there before. This lion and bear ain't nothing like this Goliath. Goliath was 9 feet tall. He was from the tribe of Gath. Those were some big men, y'all. And David was merely a little boy. And Saul even told David, he says, David, there's no way possible that I can let you go out and fight against this big man. There's no way possible that I can see you going to fight Goliath. Because I need you to understand that those are some warriors. David, all you did was take out a little lion and a little bear. But may I tell you, if it had not been for the lion and the bear, David would not have been able to conquer his Goliath. So Saul just began to speak down. Even if something how people do you, when you know you're anointed, when you know God has called you and God has purpose for your life, they'll begin to throw up your imperfections and say, listen, you ain't big enough. You ain't smart enough. You ain't tall enough. Saul said, listen, David, you're too young. He said, listen, you ain't but a little boy. And this is a grown man. He said, all you did was keep your daddy's sheep. And this man been fighting since he was a child. But may I tell you that the God I serve is an ultimate fighter. The God I serve is able to conquer any enemy. The God I serve, he's able. Slap your neighbor. A high five and say, neighbor. Come on, you gotta say it like you're preaching now. Say, neighbor. Neighbor. My God is a fighter, and he lives in me. So tell him, it's fighting me, baby. Slap your neighbor, high five, and say, I got fight in me. We'll be right back. you to understand that David did not care how big Goliath was. See, David understood that that didn't even matter. And may I tell you, you got to take on the mindset of David. It does not matter how big the situation looks that you're going through right now. It does not matter how strong the situation seems to be. It does not matter how long the situation has been there. Because I understand that just like God allowed me to conquer the lion and the bear, God is able to allow me to take down this situation. I know it looks big, but you can take it. I know it looks strong, but you can take it. I know it looks hard, but you can make it through. Because I've got fight in me. Is there anybody in this house? Come on, women, shout back at me. You know how it was when you was in high school. And they will come up to you sometime and say, listen, girl, you know I got a fight today after school.